views expressed on this program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of the station, its management, or other advertisers. You're listening to Transformation Talk Radio.
Hi, welcome. This is Dr. John DeMartini. This is one of the most amazing and inspiring shows that you can listen into. If you want to be on the edge of your seats, if you want to open up your heart, if you want to expand your mind, and you want to meet incredible people, stay tuned because you're just about to experience a transformative radio show that will change your life. And you're listening to the Dr. Pat Show that's coming up right next.
The following audio is via a Skype call.
Welcome to the Dr. Pat Show, talk radio to thrive by. Powerful, inspiring, and coming to you live, bringing you stories of people like you and me, busting through and living life full out. Get ready to dare to wonder what your life would be like if you knew you could not fail.
Hey, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. You know, in the last show, you heard me talk about, you know, how my life has definitely shifted to one of looking at leading with my spiritual connection, my connection to whatever that is, the God of your understanding, a higher self, whatever you call it. I talked about how important that's been for me. I also talked about the fact that, you know, I didn't pop into this world like that. But I learned what that connection means, especially when you're not well. Today, I am so thrilled to have Dr. Abraham Jaffe joining us here today. Dr. Jaffe is somebody that is going to be bringing this message, a journey into spiritual healing, one of the most powerful messages, I believe, of our time. And, you know, I'm not just talking from a very, you know, personal, commonsensical point of view. I'm talking from a very important perspective now on what we have found ancient times of healing. And now modern quantum physics is talking about today. Recently, my friends emailed me about a very serious concern that they have in the Lyme disease community on what's happening. But I want to say this, all of the above, how does it point to our connection to what's possible in healing? That's what Dr. Jaffe is about. You know, he has merged the excellence of traditional medicine, including its diagnostic capabilities, testing, labs, treatments, with the beauty of spiritual healing to provide what I like to call a whole system, a comprehensive system of relief to those of you that are suffering from disease, illness, or seeking to know God. Now, why is it that we're doing this? Well, if you are someone that has, like we talked about in the last show, suffering from some kind of addiction, there is an opening that happens. That opening that happens, we hear time and time and time and time again, happens from our connection to God, our connection to the divine. Dr. Jaffe has helped patients all over the world heal from serious diseases. And we're going to hear about this in this incredible radio show, video show, live show, all of the above we're doing. Today, though, this is my honor and great pleasure to having you understand, get to know, and be part of what the journey is like. Dr. Jaffe, thank you so much for today.
Thank you, Pat. It's my pleasure to be with you and with your audience out there. I'm looking forward to helping people understand what's possible and not to give up with the basic understandings that we have today in general medicine, but to know that there is so many realms of healing, and the greatest, of course, is spiritual healing. It's the highest.
Totally.
Because healing, there's nothing further than God. I mean, that's where it stops there. So we have to go to the highest, the most high, and all the way down to the materialistic side. And when we bring them together, then we have the greatest chance for people to have success and healing. And that's what this journey is about.
Yeah. And, you know, I love that, you know, you and I met, and I love that we're talking about this now, because when we look in the world and we're looking at, and let's just call it statistics now, statistics of all levels that have come out, there's some things that we've learned about spirituality, especially from the addiction arena, but more importantly, that we've learned in connecting the dots between ancient healing, ancient ideas, and the connection to God. I'm on a mission, and I'll tell you why. I do not want people to go through what I went through to have to figure this out. No way. You know, but maybe sometimes we do, right?
Well, you know, I think we all, you know, disease is a way to come back to our spirituality. And when you understand it, you know, as you learned, you know, at the end of the day, that's what healed you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's really the same for everybody, that we can, you know, for example, we could take, if somebody comes with a breast cancer and we go ahead and we give you a mastectomy and we take out the breast, what have we done with the causes of the breast cancer? What happens to them? Well, my experience is they actually go inside the body deeper. And if you push it in deeper, sooner or later, it's kind of like a trampoline. It's going to rebound out and you're going to get an explosion at some point and it's going to come out someplace else.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. That is, you know, I'll tell you what, if I'd have heard those words, like, I don't know, 2004, how old am I now? What are we doing? I mean, if I'd have been able to know you and understand the work you're doing that is so powerful in the world, that's why I'm so excited about what we're doing together, because time is of the essence, Dr. Jeffy. Time is of the essence. Every day there's a new report. There's something that says, oh, you know what? We kind of really need to look at something different. But what about your journey? What brought you, you know, this amazing doctor, this person that has been out in the world? How did your calling come to be? I mean, for me, I talk about dialing a wrong phone number, but now I have a little different view of it. How about you?
Well, I mean, there's a lot of stories, but the one I like the best is in my residency in Chicago. I was at University of Illinois. I was gifted with a young 17-year-old girl who was dying of hepatitis. You know, she had basically an acute hepatitis that had come into her. And I came up to the ICU, and she ended up being my first patient as an ICU doctor as I was working through that part of my residency. And I remember that when I touched her, you know, and I wasn't really that energy sensitive or spiritual at that point. You know, I've been through medical school, but when I touched her, I remember that it was as if a cold chill jumped out of my body, out of her body into me. And I felt like I shriveled up almost in terror and kind of fell into myself. And I didn't know what was going on with her, but I was very frightened. And this cold sense of what happened was going on. So after that, I was kind of, you know, afraid to really even touch her, to really examine her. But it turns out that this girl had been part of one of the Jewish academies in Chicago. Mm. And the Jewish academy, which was very small, I don't think they had more than, you know, maybe a couple hundred or even 150 students, that in their senior class, or in their classes, they had lost like four or five students that year from that had died, which was like an unbelievable thing that was going on. So,
wow, that's enormous.
Yeah. What was, you know, what was happening? Why were they dying? And why were these people, you know, leaving? So here this girl, you know, this shows up, and we tried everything. I mean, it was a big thing in Chicago. Everybody was trying to heal her. Chicago, University of Chicago, Chicago Medical, Rush St. Luke's, everybody was working on trying to heal the girl. Nothing was working. She was just dying. And at that time, the rabbis, the Orthodox rabbis, called to Jerusalem, to their head rabbi, and said, is there a secret ancient, anything in the ancient Judaic lore that would heal, you know, hepatitis? And they went into the Talmud, the textbooks, and they found this this healing. And the healing was that they brought a bunch of doves into the ICU. And they said that if you put the dove on top of the girl, the dove would essentially pull out the light of the hepatitis and would die. So they got the head of medicine to agree to that. They brought in all these doves. Also, they must have been like at least 20 rabbis as well. It was a very intense moment. And I was going to watch it. I wanted to see this. I was very interested. But, you know, it was interesting. The rest of the hospital went into absolute panic, chaos, fire, rage, hatred even. How dare you bring in doves? How dare you do something different? You know, just give her the cortisone. If she dies, she dies. And that's the end of the story. So, you know, I wasn't okay with that. And the head of medicine wasn't okay with that. So we the rabbis were allowed in. I walked into the room and I watched. They took this dove out of the box and they put, you know, they placed it over the belly button of the girl. And remember, I touched that girl and that darkness came out of her into me. I kind of knew what that poor animal was going to get.
Wow.
And the same thing happened. Whatever was in her went into that dove. The dove kind of yelled and passed out. I would say within 1.5-2 seconds, it was dead. And they went through over the next few hours, 18 doves, each one taking longer and longer to die.
Wow.
And while it was happening, the vital signs of the girl were being corrected, you know, by the nurse, because they do it every 5-10 minutes. They check the vital signs. By the 18 doves later, she was completely normal. Everything had normalized in her, and she had started her healing process. She was coming back. It was really one of the most incredible things I had ever seen in my life. And what I came out of it was with one understanding was that traditional medicine was incomplete and that there were hidden secret forms of healing that were beyond traditional medicine and that we needed to merge the two fields together instead of the separation. Oh, I'm medical, so I can't do spiritual. I'm spiritual, I can't do medical. I'm homeopathic, I can't do allopathic. You know who loses with this? The patient.
Yeah. Yeah. Loses big time. You know, I think I mentioned to you my friend, colleague, Dr. Dan Cohen, who neuroscientist, renowned, like you, right? But in the same way, you know, he decided, listen, there's got to be a spiritual element to this. There's got to be a way to so he creates the Soul Tech Lounge, which you think about it, you go look at it up online, it's a chair. And what he's done is he's taken these vibrations, and think about this, right, what you just said about the dove. If we go back in ancient times, right, and we look at some of the ancient practices, you know, whether it's music and sound, vibration, right? So he creates his chair, and it's a Soul Tech, and he's got the speakers in the chair. And he gives me one of these, and the state of meditation that it puts me in, strengthening my connection to the divine, it's hard to explain it. But when you're really not well, right, we all need something to help us make that connection. But look at what you've done. You've opened up the platform to allow for infinite possibilities. Isn't that what you've done in your journey?
That's right, because you've actually nailed it right on the nose, which is great. In healing, it is the realm of infinite possibility where the healing comes down from. And the question is really, how do we access that realm and draw forth the healing from that realm, which actually is the source of true spiritual healing?
Right on that.
Now, the only difference, you know, that I can say is that in the realm of infinite possibility, the one who chooses what manifests is actually God. So it's actually the will of God that ultimately brings forth the realm of infinite possibility. People think that we do it, but in fact, all the spiritual teachers that I know, including myself, would agree that it's not us really pulling it forth, that ultimately it begins with God sending it down. So what we have to learn how to do for healing is support the body, care for the body, deepen the body, help the body get, you know, strong with herbs and nutrition, all that type of thing. But at the same time, we have to access the will of God to actually open the realm of infinite possibility so that the true healing can be sent down for any disease. And that is possible, assuming it's God's will to do that.
You know, Dr. Jeffrey, let's take a short break here for a minute. And when we come back, we're going to talk about what does God want? What is this energy of openness and not attachment? What is this energy? What is it about those of us that have been so rock bottom, nobody could figure it out? What happens when we're open to the possibilities? What happens when the angel lady says to me, I think you got a T3 problem? What happens when I actually listen to that? Stay tuned. Dr. Jaffe's in the house. We're going to be doing an entire series with him because healing is not just on his mind. It's in his heart and in his essence. We'll be right back.
Transformation Talk Radio is dedicated to the education and awareness of Lyme disease.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Lyme Talk Radio. I'm Dr. Pat, joined here by
Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
Dr. Pat Basile and Dr. Nusheen Darvish will be bringing the most innovative, groundbreaking information, research, treatment innovations, and stories from those it affects every day.
I'm so excited to be talking about this.
We have so much to share.
Dr. Darvish and I are planning to do is connect the dots.
People suffering with all sorts of chronic diseases, it's time. It is time for them to transform.
Tune into Lyme Talk Radio and help keep our mission strong.
For the loyal listeners out there that have been listening to this incredible show on Lyme disease, we are not going to let you down. We're going to come through stronger and enrich the platform for Lyme disease awareness through Lyme Talk Radio. The message will continue, the conversations will become stronger, and the healing epic.
Are you looking for the perfect setting for your next workshop or retreat? At Spirit Fire Meditative Retreat Center, cultivating consciousness is what we do best. Our guests count on us to create an atmosphere that supports serenity and well-being. We lead from the heart and create space for the mind. Freshly prepared meals designed with local and organic ingredients, 95 acres of beautiful woods and pastures, and a facility built with green in mind. This is what you'll find at Spirit Fire. For more information, visit spiritfireretreatcenter.com.
Hi there, my name is Audrey Michelle, host of Rewired Life Radio and a spiritual growth coach. I talk about this all the time on my show, listening to your body and acting on intuition. What do these things even mean? Here's the thing. About 10 years ago, I figured out I was doing it all wrong. I mean, I wasn't unhappy, but was I really happy? And then life sent me a spiritual smackdown, like it does, because I wasn't listening to my best resource, my body and my intuition. I was living from a place of fear. I was stressed and I was in pain, and I seemed to be happily unhappy. Mostly, I just didn't know what I didn't know. And what I didn't know was that my body and my intuition had all the tools I needed to live life as my best self. I'm sharing the tools I have learned over the last 10 years of my healing journey in my online class, Soul Awakening, beginning September 19th. Learn more. Go to audreymichelle.com/awaken. That's Audrey Michelle, spelled MICHEL.com/awaken.
Is traditional medicine not working for you? Do you still feel as if your health isn't 100%? Here at the Holistic Medical Center, Dr. Nusheen Darvish and the qualified staff look through the dimensions of wellness and start a healing plan prioritized to your needs. Our physicians assess the whole you until complete health is achieved. Get the help you need by visiting drdarvish.com or call 425-451-0404.
Hey, everybody, welcome back. I'm Dr. Pat.
I'm Dr. Jaffe.
Now, we are here today, both of us, because I'm introducing all of you to Dr. Jaffe, Dr. Jaffe's work, you know, a journey into spiritual healing. The reason this is so important, we're going to be doing an entire series with Dr. Jaffe because, you know, learning to heal disease and yourself, you know, is something that is on the forefront. It's heavy. It's heavy on all of our minds. And why is that? Well, turn on your television, if you will, and then watch what happens. What are the commercials about? Now, what they don't tell you is that part of disease, the causes of disease, you know, go far beyond what we hear in traditional, conventional mainstream. See, we're really the new mainstream. You know, we are here today as one show of an entire series we're going to be doing because he, Dr. Jaffe, is on a mission. I'm on a mission. But this is really the mission for you all. You all. Dr. Jaffe, you know, we're talking about this connection. We're talking about this discovery. We're talking about what it means now to get closer, not to bury down those things which have caused disease to thrive, right? And what you bring to the forefront of this is getting closer to God, to hope, to peace, to love, to oneness. Now, that has to be an incredible journey that you went on to discover that.
Right. Well, you know, in Sufism, and I'm a Sufi teacher, what we learn is what is the purpose of our lives? It's the foundational reason that we're here. And of course, most people, you know, it's about success, it's about raising the kids, things like that. But what we really learn is that we've been created to know God. That the reason we're here is really a spiritual reason. It's not a physical reason. It's a spiritual reason. We're here to know God. So that brings to what does it mean to know God? Well, knowing God means to know the attributes of God and to know the essence of God. So there are attributes and essence of God. So an attribute might be something like the compassion, divine compassion, or divine love, or divine peace, where the essence is the very source, it's the heart that emanates all the attributes of things. So the human being spiritually, its job is to purify its human nature, to learn the divine nature so it can come closer to the reality itself. Okay, so that means if you think about a human being, they may not have a lot of compassion. Maybe as a child, they got hurt, so they lost their compassion. And now they're, you know, 30, 40, 50 years old, and all of a sudden they have lost their compassion. Or maybe as a child, they got wounded, so they didn't learn to give the love.
Yeah.
You know, maybe, and their mom didn't give them the love or something like that happened. So now they don't know how to give the love. So what happens is that the human nature gets veiled in the sense of the love is not complete, the compassion is not complete, and we call that the human attributes. But the divine is beyond. So the divine is full of love, full of compassion, unlimited compassion, and infinite love, infinite healing. So what we're really trying to do is go beyond ourselves to reach the experience of that unlimited nature, that unlimited attributes of compassion and love and peace and all those things, to be able to complete our spiritual journey as human beings. That's really what we're doing here. Now, as a spiritual healer, and I've done this now for probably 30 years, the bottom line of all illness is about essentially acquiring those attributes. The illnesses have come to teach us how to reach, to become compassionate, how to become loved, and that type of thing. So this is really, people don't really understand that yet because we're not taught that. But if you have, let's say, you know, congestive heart failure, your heart's failing, and you go, congestive heart failure is all about the ability to receive love.
Yeah.
You know, and if you can't receive, you block it, your heart eventually fails. So it's teaching people to be able to receive love. Now, we can give you lots of medical drugs to keep your heart pumping to a certain level, But, you know, after 4, 5, 6 years, people look at just heart failure, the drugs don't work anymore.
Yeah.
You know, and they're going into that end stage failure. But the funny part about it, if you really clear the issues that have caused them to go into lack of receiving love or connection to God to receive divine love, many, many times, even end stage heart disease turns around. And that's incredible, because in traditional medicine, we would say, you know, this is end game. It's over.
Yeah.
But it's not over. There's so much possibility and so much hope. And we have to, you know, as you and I and people like us, we have to, you know, get this message out that we're not cutting from traditional medicine. I love traditional medicine, but, you know, it's not the only thing we need to do. We need to bring in the spirit. We need to bring in the healing of, you know, what's going on inside of us. And most importantly, we have to get that connection back up to those attributes and to that essence. And when we embody that, that is when you see miracles happen. That's been my experience. The miracles happen,
yeah.
That happens. And that's what we're looking for.
I remember, and you have many stories like this, and we're going to talk about them as well. You know, I had a friend that had experienced a brain aneurysm, not the right term. It was a from the vein instead of the artery, right? But it was the same effect, and went into the hospital, and I'll never forget this for as long as I live. And Dr. Racy's was the neurosurgeon, neurologist, I don't even have the right terms, but that's not my point. But we were in holding a prayer circle before the spinal tap. So we were in, lights were out, prayer circle, a little battery operated candle, because you know what happens when you light a candle in a hospital, right? Okay, right. Battery. And so the nurse is like getting panicked, absolutely out of her mind. Dr. Racy, you're keeping him waiting. You're keeping him waiting. And he was at the door. We weren't finished. We're in the middle of doing a special treatment for wholeness and wellness. And he came in and he brought the nurse out. And he said to the nurse, there are some things you don't interrupt. This is one of them. And in he comes. It was very risky. The person he was doing it with was definitely totally freaked out about needles, right? Comes in, honors the prayer, right? The next thing you know, he was in and out. And the person that was laying there was like, when are you going to start? See, this is just one example. But isn't it an important one, Dr. Jaffe?
Well, I mean, again, what you did in that prayer circle was you brought in the divine presence and the angels and all sorts of spiritual help that made a difference in that person's healing. You know, for example, you may not have known, but it's very possible that an angel guided his needle, you know, where before, you know, he may not, you know, with an aneurysm, you have to exactly get it in the right spot, you know. You know, you can't miss it. If you want to get it. But that angel knows exactly where to put. You know, with me, you know, there are names that you can use, names of God that we use.
Yeah.
When, for example, my daughter had a thing she needed to get a shot. She's only 6 years old, my youngest one. And, you know, I said, we're going to just say this name. And we said the name. And they put the needle in. She never felt it. She wanted to know, when's the needle coming? And it was all done already. And she never felt the needle go in. You know, so we can change a lot of things through, you know, sacred sound and through calling forth the attributes and the angels and all these things. And you were doing that. And I promise you that you helped that person. I'm certain of it.
You know, there are, you know, in what you do and how you help, there are reasons that people receive miraculous healing. Now, I will tell you this, and then I would love to hear what the reasons are in your experience, what you've seen, because this is how you help people. You know, this is how you, Dr. Jaffe, are saving lives. In my friend's case, they could not understand how this thing that was bleeding miraculously stopped. Even the neuro guy, Dr. Racy's, was like, we don't know. Here's your x-ray. Look at this thing. We don't know how it stopped. But you have this knowledge and wisdom of why people receive miraculous healing. I would love for you to share that with us.
Yeah, well, I mean, again, I'll use a story because story is the best way.
Yeah.
And I may have told you this story, I can't remember, but when I was, a number of years ago, I was up in Minneapolis, and I met a man who was dying of melanoma. And he had a large melanoma on his face, and it was slowly killing him. He had been a survivor of the Nazi war camps, and he was in his 70s at that time. And, you know, the woundedness of being in the camps had basically broken his trust in God. So he had this thing, and he was very New Age, and he was doing, you know, the kind of energy work we see today. And the tumor was changing shape. And this is what we see a lot in tumors, is that when they do energy work, the tumor will shift around. You get all this shape changing, but it doesn't go away. So the missing piece is always this return to God. So for me, the miracles come down to two things: working on the issues and purifying them inside yourself, the causative levels, and the return to God. Those are the two key pieces.
Mm-hmm.
So he one day realized that his rage at God because of the deaths of his family in the camps, he had left God, and he realized that he was dying now and he needed to make his peace with God, which he did. He said he cried for like 2-3 days straight, you know, just literally nonstop sobbing. And at the end of the, I don't know, second or third day, he fell asleep. And in the sleep, he had a dream. And in the dream, an angel came to him and had reached into his face and took the tumor out, showed it to him, and then disappeared. And then he woke up. And he kind of woke up with the dream on his mind, and he went out to the bathroom, and he went to the mirror. And lo and behold, in the mirror, the tumor had disappeared instantaneously.
Yeah. You know, I hear these stories and I think to myself, you know, right now we're looking at, you know, Senator John McCain with a brain tumor. And, you know, I was thinking about him and preparing to chat with you today and share this with our listeners and to experience what he has experienced here recently. You know, my heart goes out for him, because if he were sitting across from you today, I know you would be able to help him. I know it. I know there are things of the heart. Now, you help people all over the world. You do workshops. You're available. How can people attend workshops? How can they learn this? How can they learn what you know? You have many ways to do this. Can you share a few of them with us?
Yeah. Well, first of all, they can go to my website, drjaffemd.com. drjaffemd.com, or you can go to soupyhealer.com. I'll take you to the same place. And I do have very simple introductory workshops that teach people basic self-healing and the connection to God, so we start them at that level. And then for more intensive cases, if you have cancer, for example, or you're in the ICU, or you're having something more intense going on, we have foundation courses. These are, they meet for about 2 to 3 months, and you will work with one of our healers in a group process to really get to the root of your illness, what's causing it inside of you. And you'll learn how to connect to these attributes of God to purify it. And the results are usually very, very profound. We've seen, you know, incredible healings in even 7-8 weeks where people have had congestive heart failure disappear. We've had people with all sorts of illnesses, prostate problems, breast problems, you name it, that have changed radically in just 7 or 8 weeks. So this is what their basic course. And of course, for those of you that really have, you know, very deep disease, then we have a year course of self-healing where you will learn to really get to the root of your illness. You know, what is really causing it? And it's usually fairly, you know, most serious disease, life-threatening disease particularly, there are very deep issues going on, you know, both with your heart, with your soul, with your personality, with the traumas, the stresses in your life. you've got to get to those, and you have to respond and clear those in yourself. If you do, much of the time, your traditional medicine kicks in and works. If you don't do it, it may or may not work. And sometimes just by doing it, it just clears spontaneously and it's over. So we see all those different things, spontaneous healing. We see all of a sudden, you know, people who were getting chemo, it didn't work. All of a sudden now it works. Why? Because the thing that was blocking it was removed. And if you really look deeply, what was blocking it was really God saying, I want you to understand compassion. I'm not going to take this away from you until you do. Or I want you to learn love, and I'm not going to take your heart disease away from you until you learn to love. But when you learn it, by God, I'll take it from you in a moment. And yeah. That's my experience of it.
Yeah. You know what I love about this, too, is we're now seeing in our pop culture, believe it or not, I'm going to bring a little pop culture in here if I could. You know, we're now seeing in our pop culture in this country at the moment, we're seeing messages come to the forefront about love. Nobody thought in a million years that we would have a blockbuster movie like Wonder Woman, whose main message, the movie ends with her belief in love, choosing love. That's how it ends. Even if you don't watch any other part of the movie, that's what she has represented, you know, for comic book decades. But I want to ask you this other question. In scriptures, I don't care which one you pick up from what spiritual philosophy. If you pick up the Bible, you will read God is everything or God is nothing. God either is or God isn't. What will you choose? This is the message. And yet with this message across religions, just completely across, we just really having a hard time getting that one. What do you think blocks us from that?
Well, you know, there's we say in Sufism, there's two opponents to God inside the human being. And one of them is the self. You know, the self, if the self has to give up its authority to accept God inside. The self doesn't want to do that. Self-desire, you know, we want what we want, and we all want that. But our self-desires often lead us astray. They lead us into suffering. They lead us into pain. You know, we want that alcohol. We desire it. We drink it. And then we become an alcoholic, and we still want it. But that doesn't mean that desire is healthy for us or for our families. So if you follow, you know, God, God would say, don't become addicted. Don't use that in a way that's wrong, you know, or don't use it at all because you're not able to handle it. And so the person has to make a decision, first of all, between self-desire and godly desire. And that's very hard for most people. You know, the second thing is a little bit darker and unfortunately a little bit more disturbing, but there are things in the world that bring in these shadow elements, and like this shooting that we just saw today in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
You know, what happened there? You know, why does this man, you know, supposedly, you know, in his early 60s, you know, go out and shoot 58 people and, you know, injure 500 people? You know, what happened? Well, you know, again, if you look at the deeper understandings, God really doesn't want these things where these games of chance, where unfortunately these shadow elements come in. And when somebody who's unstable, who has some kind of, you know, psychiatric issue gets into a situation like that, these forces can get into them and they will bring up hate. They'll bring up violence. They'll bring up negativity and they will turn people from God. That's what happened in this case. Something got into that man. And, you know, maybe I'm not sure how or what was happening that it did, but I know that it did. I can feel it. And then he acted out on it. So, you know, going back to your question, you know, God's will is always of love and it's always of beauty. It's always of perfection. It's always of peace. And it's always of the highest for every human being. The human will is selfish in the sense that it essentially is sensual. It wants what makes us feel good. But sometimes what makes us feel good, cocaine, alcohol, sexuality, these type of things can actually destroy us. So the self thing is sort of, you know, it has an up and a down to it. And then the shadow elements, these darker elements, they do not want good at all. They want to really do things that aren't right. So these things are impacting in our subconscious all the time. And we are receiving messages from them all the time. And unless we learn to distinguish and discern what is God's will, what is the self's will, what are these shadow element will, we are going to get caught in these lower natures and we're going to fight against God. And that's why religion again and again talks about it, but very few people actually actualize it.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Let's take a short break, Dr. Jaffe. When we come back, we're going to talk about what the invitation is. We're going to make sure folks know how to get a hold of you, how to find out about, you know, the great work you're doing in the world. But when we come back, we're going to talk about this journey. And the journey is one of invitation. The journey is one of seeking. What is it that you can know about this to bring this at your very doorstep? Not a year from now, not 20 years from now, but now. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Did you know that all of the shows on the Transformation Radio Network are available as podcasts to stream or download?
Really?
Check us out. Go to transformationradio.fm. We have business shows, spiritual shows, energy healing shows, and pretty much everything in between. Something for everyone guaranteed to inspire, educate, and transform. We are transforming the world, one listener at a time.
Tune into the wisdom of your soul for guidance on living a joyful life. On Soul Wisdom Radio, Wendy will provide inspiration to raise your vibration and connect with your higher self and guides. Learn how to balance your ego and to progress spiritually on Soul Wisdom Radio with Wendy Rose Williams. Visit WendyRoseWilliams.com or Transformation Talk Radio to learn more about a healing session with Wendy and her events and publications.
Be you plus live your purpose equals joy. That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that are meant to make the world brighter. Each show will feature an art visioning journal prompt to help you create your way to soul clarity. If you're ready to get unstuck and create more joy, this show is for you.
Tune in the first and third Tuesday at 3 p.m. Pacific on Transformation Talk Radio. For more information, visit VickiWorldArt.com.
Tune in each month to Synergenetic Living Radio, where Rick and Grace Paris discuss the synergenetic way of life, what it means to truly change your perspective in life, what it means to take control of your life and manifest your true desires. For more information on Rick and Grace Paris and Synergenetic Living, check out SynergeneticLiving.com. Get clear on the life you desire and the current life you are creating and what is between the two. Synergenetic Living, living life loud.
Tune in to the hit show, Raging Skillet Radio, mouthing off with Chef Rossi. Chef Rossi mouths off about different subjects in pursuit of breaking down walls and opening up your minds. She and Dr. Pat banter back and forth, taking from the headlines of the day on subjects that reach beyond what goes on in the world into your hearts. And go to theragingskillet.com to find out more and let Chef Rossi know what's on your mind.
Are you ready to stop stress, anxiety, and low self-esteem from running your life? Join award-winning author Dr. Friedemann Schaub for Empowerment Radio and learn breakthrough solutions to switch out of survival mode and approach every day with great ease, joy, and purpose. Tune in the first and third Wednesday at 11 a.m. Pacific to Empowerment Radio with host Dr. Friedemann Schaub on Transformation Talk Radio. Visit thefearandanxietysolution.com to learn more.
Hey, everybody. I'm so thrilled to welcome you all back. As many of you know, I'm Dr. Pat.
I'm Dr. Ibrahim Jaffe.
Dr. Jaffe is my very special co-host joining me here today, as well as many shows we're going to do together. Because like I am, and like all of us here at Transformation Talk Radio, we're on a mission. So is Dr. Jaffe. He's teaching people. He's helping people. You know, he's taking his years of studying in the medical profession and now bringing to the forefront a complete picture of what healing looks like, not just for a handful of people, but for anyone on the planet that wants to know. Dr. Jaffe, again, tell folks about the workshops you have, about the opportunities and possibilities you created for people, not just to learn how to heal themselves, but how to help others.
You can go to my website, drjaffemd.com, drjaffemd.com, or sufihealer.com will both take you there. And there's a lot of workshops, both for people wanting to self-heal. In other words, if you have an illness or you're suffering, or even you're having trouble with your connection to God, your spirituality, we have programs to help you to resolve what's going on inside of yourself. You know, what might be bailing you or blocking you or causing you from having success, from finding a relationship. All this coming from inside yourself. Once you get hold of it and you understand it and you purify it, you'll be amazed at almost instantaneously how fast things change.
And the shows we're going to be doing together, there are so many things we're going to be talking about here moving forward and opportunities that are being created for people to learn that, you know, learning and understanding how to heal ourselves, there's nothing that is outside the realm of that, not healing our issues with money, family, relationship, even God. I mean, it's all available.
Exactly. And the spiritual healing, the journey to spiritual healing, is really a journey of two sides. It's the journey of understanding, you know, what is going on inside of ourselves. And the other side of that understanding is really what is the Most High asking of us to learn so that we can be better people, you know, and healthier people. And of course, the other side of spiritual journey is the ability to learn how to transform the places in ourself in a very easy and quick way. In other words, it's not rocket science. It's actually very simple. A lot of it is just learning how to bring in the realm of infinite possibility, the realm of the divine, and bring that into those causative levels. And when those two connect, you will often see, you know, the most magical things happen in your healing. So that's really, at the end of the day, really what it's about. We'll apply it across the board, but that's what we're going to be doing.
You know, people comment when they come in my home, and they're pretty surprised. You know, there was a term that a pastor gave me once, smiling. He was smiling, and he said, You're like a spiritual hitchhiker, aren't you? And I looked at him and I said, is that a compliment? And he laughed and he said, you know, another way to think about it is you're hungry to learn. This is an opportunity for people to step in, to fill that empty void. See, there's this, you know, what does hunger mean? It means we're empty, right? If we're empty, how do we even begin to heal, Dr. Jaffe?
Well, again, if you look inside, our culture today essentially creates emptiness. What are we taught? We're not taught to bring meaning into our life. You don't get that in school, right? What you get right. is you know, how to look good, how to make money, how to act good. But the meaning in life is broken. We don't really lose our sense of meaning. And then as we get older, we start to look for that. Where is the meaning? You know, what is life about? Why are we here? What are we doing? And usually those questions get unresolved because we're too busy picking up the kids and taking them to soccer and running around town and you know, doing all the things we have to do to take care of our kids and our families. And all of a sudden now we're 40, 50 years old and another 10, 15 years have gone by and this question about meaning has never been answered. You know, and that's the emptiness Dr. Pat's talking about. We hit this place, we don't know who we are anymore. We don't know why we're here, what we're doing, you know, and all that gusto of the youth is disappeared, and now we're just, you know, our kids are growing up and we're tired and we're saying, who are we? And we're empty. Well, the answer is that meaning is hidden in our souls. That meaning is hidden in our relationship to God. And I'm speaking about the meaning in you. In other words, relationship to God doesn't mean that you have to become like somebody else tells you to be. Relationship to God is about God showing you your innate creation, what you are, what's special about you, what's perfect about you, what is meaningful to you. And, you know, my personal experience as a physician is that at the end of the day, meaning at all the deaths that I've sat with, and there have been many, many as my years as a physician, that at the very end, the two things that show up again and again is love and one's relationship to God over and over again. At the last minute, that's what people think about. Do I love my family? Am I complete with my children? Have I said goodbye to my husband or my wife? What's happening here? You know, was I a good parent? Was I a good wife, a good husband? And what's going to happen to me? You know, where am I going? And did I live a life of meaningfulness? And am I going to heaven? Am I going to hell? You know, some people, of course, they believe in other things, but they still ask the same questions. What's going to happen to me now? What was the meaning of my life? So the answer, for all the listeners out there, is we have been taught, you have been taught not to believe in your innate essence and innate truth that lives inside of you. You've been taught to follow untruth, and it is causing an intense pain and suffering inside. And when you reconnect to your truth, when you reconnect to the truth, when you reconnect to God and to love, you will see such meaning and beauty that will open up inside of you, and you'll see your life turn around. You're going to see incredible changes, such hope. You'll see miracles, miracles in the form of your kids giving up drugs, miracles in the form of jobs that didn't exist showing up, you know, miracles in the form of, you know, one of your children who never had a relationship all of a sudden falling in love. I mean, these are the beautiful miracles of life, and they come really through meaning and through connection. So let's learn how to do that. The Journey in Spiritual Healing will teach you this connection. It's going to teach you how to trust it. It's going to teach you how to look at religion in a different way, not as a dogma, not as a way that oppresses you or forces you to do things, but as a living way of love and beauty and goodness and trust and honor and respect. And in the end, you'll see yourself becoming full of light and wisdom. That's really where we're going.
Yeah, and it really is the connection and the series that we're doing together, you know, to build this connection, to strengthen the connection. And, you know, what I love about, you know, your message and what you're bringing forward is it doesn't matter where you are today in this journey. Doesn't matter. This is really for everyone. You know, you could be somebody that feels completely connected 24/7 or not connected at all. And, you know, you and I both know that it doesn't matter what point you start, does it?
No, you can start anywhere you are because that's where you are. Or you're going to say you start where you are.
Right.
And just because, you know, you've been hurt by other spiritual teachings or you've had things that have happened and your religious upbringing or anything else like that, you know what? All of that is healable. And I'm not a person who wants to put any dogma on anybody. I want to teach people to find the truth inside their own hearts and the love inside their own hearts. That's the best.
I love it. And Dr. Jaffe, thank you for today. One last question, and please give out your website. What's your personal message? What would you love to leave us with today? And I'm so looking forward to the conversations we're going to have.
Thank you, Pat. My message is very simple. You know, if you turn to your relationship to the divine, bring that into your life and understand how to do it, that all disease, all illness, all suffering can be transmuted and healing can happen in an easy way.
Mm. I love it. For those of you that want to find out more about Dr. Jaffe, we've given you a couple of websites. Dr. Jaffe, J-A-F-F, as in Frank, EMD.com or SufiHealer.com. Dr. Jaffe, thank you so much for all you do in the world.
My pleasure, Pat. Thank you for having me on your show and being a co-host with you.
All right. We're just warming up. For those of you, thank you for tuning us in and turning us on. Remember, we've got another show coming up right here on Transformation Talk Radio. If you have missed any part of this today, it will replay again tonight on TransformationTalkRadio.com. And remember this from me. It really doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what you believe or how you believe it. The door of possibilities is open. And it is an all-inclusive opportunity. We'll see you next time.
The preceding audio was via a Skype call.